And it's time for another edition of the Q Playlist. And today I'm glad to welcome Kevin Drew. Some of you will know that name as the frontman of indie collective Broken Social Scene. He's also put out 2 solo records, co-founded the influential Arts and Crafts record label, and worked with dozens of other artists. He's always there supporting other acts at shows or telling you about the new band you need to hear. And Kevin Drew's enthusiasm for art doesn't stop at music. An exhibit of his drawings called Skid Marks for the Soul opens today at the Analog Gallery in Toronto. It's a rare solo effort from a guy whose career has largely been about collaboration. He's here to share songs from some of those collaborators and tell us how they influenced him creatively over the years. Kevin Drew is here with me in Studio Q. My man, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
So as I said, many people know you, of course, for your music, but they might not know you also make visual art.
Yeah.
How would you describe what you do in terms of your visual art?
I am of the belief that everyone is an artist. If you really just want to take pencil to paper or crayons to paper, I've always loved children's art. I've always embraced smudges and pastels and oils. I've done artwork. I did the cover for the
second,
the self-titled one.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's always been something I've loved to do just for myself. And recently it just kind of came together that there might be an unveiling of this to the
public. Did you just get like a big rush of inspiration, started making a whole bunch of stuff? Is that what happened?
Yeah, I always believe in the moment whenever you're creating anything. And I have a hard time with doing vocals. I always believe it's either the first take or the 78th take. Everything in between is forced. And I don't believe in general in life forced is the way to go. And I like the natural aspects of all things when it comes to creation. And I like the idea of you just take risks and see what happens. And that's kind of what this show is all about.
Is music and visual art separate for you, or do you draw inspiration from music when you're drawing?
I think I just draw inspiration from everything that I'm doing.
Yeah.
And if I'm down, I'm down. If I'm up, I'm up. I'm a very moody person. It depends on what's happening. But I think any kind of outlet for anyone, any kind of outlet, whether it's exercise, karate, whatever you want to do, breathing, meditation, creating, drawing, painting, running, drumming, all those things are exactly what you need. And you're entitled to have.
Okay, we're going to get more into your philosophy in a bit, but I want to get into some music now. Music has obviously been such an integral thing in your life, and a big part of that has been collaborating with other artists.
Yep.
So let's get into your playlist. That's the basis for your playlist. You pick some key tracks by people you've worked with over the years, and the first song is a perfect example of that. Let's take a listen together. That was In Mind by Toronto band Do Make Say Think. Beauty of a tune. Kevin Drew is just in here freaking out just listening to the first few seconds of that. What's so meaningful about that particular track for you in this band?
This band has been the soundtrack to my life for the last 19 years. These are 5 guys that I know who are friends. And I just said to you, when you don't think of them when you're listening to their music, that means you're truly transcending. And I so believe, and as so many agree with me, at this day and age, you need a soundtrack. You need to remember to look out the window while you're listening to music. We are slaves to our phones. We all know it. They're becoming family members. They're becoming dear friends. And that's wrong. And we're getting bamboozled by that. And I can't force enough to people how now the value of music is just emotion. Well, that's great. It's a feeling. You need it. And Do Makes Say Think, they've been there. For the last many, many years
where
of my life.
Where does that song take you?
That song takes me to the beauty of life and loss, as most songs that you love do. It's a song that is about letting go, and it's an emotional ballad that makes you rise above. And I can't thank them enough for all the records that they've made.
All right, let's hear your second track now. It's by a guy who had a big hit in the 70s, but recently staged a comeback, partly thanks to you.
You say when you say
This one put a smile on both of our faces.
Wow.
That was Baron Longfellow, otherwise known as Andy Kim, with I'm Gonna Need a Miracle Tonight. Now, Andy is most famous for the song Sugar Sugar, but Kevin, you produced Andy's comeback record last year. He said you dragged him out of retirement.
Mm-hmm.
Why'd you do it?
I did it so I could spend time with him. I love that man. Very inspiring man to be around. Great stories. Was in a completely different place than where I found myself with my peers. Just so grateful, so happy, and wanted to just do it all over again. Still wanted to make it, even though he had made it time and time again.
You just wanted to be around that energy.
Yeah, I did. I found it very refreshing for me to be around a man in his 60s who's had hits, who was like a teenager when it came to music.
Hmm. Now, you're that guy. You're that guy that makes people believe. You know what I'm talking about?
I do. Thank you.
Where does that come from?
I think that when you find the best in people, you've got to bring it out in people. And I've always said I never manipulated anyone into doing anything terrible. I believe that you're better. I believe if you have great friends, that's your greatest achievement in life. And in a time of chaos right now when it comes to communication and connection, I think more than ever you need to realize that it takes a group of people, it takes to help you become who you are. Now, mm-hmm. I've had rough landings and I've done things, obviously. I sometimes spend my days living in regret of my past and fearing what's to come. But when you have a clear head about things and you believe in someone and you see the honesty in them, as I hope people do with me, then it's up to us as a group, as a union, to push the best that we can. And it comes at a cost a lot of the times. I haven't had the particularly greatest 5 years of my life, but I'm excited to get back out there and continue to try to just...
Who does that for you? Who sees
everybody in my
who
life.
Sees the best in you? Who do you kind of count on for that, to see the honesty in you?
Honestly, the people who are, if you're around me, then that's what you're doing for me. If you're standing in front of me and we've had a conversation longer for 5 minutes, I mean, I live in this town of Toronto and I know a lot of people. I have a great family. You know, my parents, my brother, they've always been there for me. And I've always said my greatest achievement are the friends that I have and the people, or the loves that I've been with, the loves I'm with. You know, this is, they're all helping, you know, and when you have a team to help you get through, it's really like no other. And I really implore to people, remember, your phones are just supposed to get you from A to B. They're not supposed to bring you that feeling.
So that's supposed to be the people in front of your face.
In front of your face.
Okay, moving on to your next pick. This band was one of the first acts you signed to your label, Arts and Crafts, when it first began in 2003.
The heart suspends, then bends it into three.
That stars with The Loose Ends Will Make Knots from their 2012 record, The North. Kevin, you have a long relationship with that band. You could have picked any song from their long career. Why is this the one you picked?
This is my favorite duet of theirs. This is my favorite song of theirs. I love the aspect of the light and darkness, the heavy, the one going down, the one trying to stay up. And I believe it's a beautiful representation, not only of their voices, Torquil Campbell and Amy Milan, but just of relationships in general, of struggling to keep going, depression, joy. How do we continue? And I listen to this song, and I've always listened to it with always an emotional little lump in my throat, because I think it describes so many relationships out there. And I think it describes a wonderful sense of what's next. And that's why I chose this song.
If you're just joining us, I'm Shad, and this is Q. And Kevin Drew is with us today playing some of his favorite tracks by some of his many collaborators. Now, next up is a band Canadians hold near and dear to their hearts.
Yeah, I know, I know, I know. It's still not enough. Nothing short of everything. Nothing short of everything's enough.
That's the Tragically Hip with their track Now for Plan A. And Kevin, you produced their new album that's coming out in June. What's it like working with a band that has such a defined sound and such a long history?
It was great. 30 years. I did it with my partner David Hamlin, and we did it up at their studio in Bath. And that was a song that we kind of discovered on our drive along the 401. It's the most sort of mundane but very meditative, peaceful drive. You just sort of head straight on your way to Kingston. And we were in the heart of working on this new record, and we were very much embraced by the guys, and it was a wonderful experience. But as we were sort of going through the back catalog, because one of the things that Gord Downie loved about Dave Hamlin and myself coming on board was that I knew the band inside out, mm-hmm. and David did not. We were going through old catalogs, and this was from their last record called Now for Plan A, and I just remember one day we were taking a drive together, and we listened to it, and I said, that's beautiful. Let's listen to it again. And then we listened to it again, and I said, that's beautiful. I'm going to listen to that one more time. And I remember hearing Gord talk about how Plan A is just, it's sort of what your original plan has always been, where you always wanted to be and where you wanted to go, but inevitably you can never get there. And there was a great moment where I said to Dave, wow, now for Plan A, what are we making? And he just kind of looked at me and said, now for Plan B. And I loved that. And that song now with Sarah Harmer singing and just knowing the guys as much as I know them now, I love it. I think it's a beautiful sentiment.
What do you love most about those guys on a personal level?
On a personal level?
Yeah.
Their struggles to keep going, to be together, a family, watching them as brothers. I mean, obviously, I'm just a student in this town. I want to be educated, and I have a band of myself, and we haven't been in the studio in 7 years. And I liked how open they were and trusting they were.
About all of those struggles?
Yeah, and bringing us in. And there was never any, you know, obviously you struggle to figure out what you're making, but there was never any resistance. Hmm. And I will always respect them for that. I really had a wonderful time. I saw them when I was 13 years old, and my brother took me to the Ontario Place Forum to see them, up to here, tour. And when this was coming about for us to possibly do this, it's not a career move for me. I want to live. I want to do all kinds of things. Mm-hmm. And working with these guys, I just thought how incredible it is to work with a band that I first saw when I was 13 years old. And I love them. I love their music. And I really had a blast with them. And I'm very grateful that they brought Dave and I along.
Beautiful. Well, it's great having you here, Kevin.
Thank you.
I look forward to the next time. I was an all-Canadian playlist of collaborators from the one and only Kevin Drew. He's a singer, songwriter, producer, label co-founder, and clearly a lover of music. And Kevin's first art show opens tonight at the Analog Gallery in Toronto. If you want to hear his playlist again, we have those tracks up at cbc.ca/Q. Kevin Drew, join me today in Studio Q.